What's good, everyone? I'm Jendrek, and today I'm gonna play Esper for my first playthrough for Patreon, and parts of those will be on YouTube as well. So I'm gonna play Esper as per usual these last couple weeks. This is the same 75 I used to win a challenge a few weeks back, and I'm not gonna talk too much about the decklist itself because I've already published a deck guide with sideboard guide on Patreon. I've published numerous videos when I'm talking about Esper, and because I assume this video will be quite lengthy anyways, I'd rather not have any redundant content that I've already shared. So yeah, let's just jump right into it. Match 1. We are on the draw against an unknown opponent who mulliganed to 6, and we are presented with a decent 7 card hand that I'm gonna keep. If they are playing creatures, then obviously Fatal Push is great. And I'm very high on Opt Snapcaster Mage hands in general. Okay, Snow Courage Forest Noble Hierarch. Wonder what's this? Noble Hierarch isn't very popular these days, really. Aside from humans, and that's not humans. With Snow Courage Forest, or with Forest of any kind, for that matter. So I assume it's either Heliod with a 1 of Noble Hierarch, or something like Banned Stoneblade. Double Forest. And Birds of Paradise, okay. No, I have no idea what this is. Okay. Supreme Verdict is likely a good draw against a deck with Mana Dorks. I think sequencing lands in this deck is kinda challenging, so don't autopilot it. And I think the best one to play is Polluted Delta, because it's more likely to get a basic planes than it is to get basic swamp with Supreme Verdict in play, or in hand rather. So I'd rather have this in play and the option of fetching a painless white source later on. Okay. I have no idea what this is. Is it just company? Some sort? Okay, I'm gonna opt in response. Maybe I hit Force of Negation. I did not, but I hit opt. And now I'll just fetch a basic island untapped. I wonder if that's Heliod, but I think it's kind of unlikely that it's Heliod with so many dorks. Oh, it is Heliod, and actually. So yeah, I guess the first challenge post-bans were... The first challenge that Heliod won post-bans was a Sunday one by Mr. Rab, and Mr. Rab played the Birds Hierarch version over the more traditional... Utopia Sprawl Arbor Elf setup. So now I'm looking for stuff like Archmage's Charm would be, or Esper Charm would be insane, because they only have 2 cards, including Ballista. I'm gonna take Mana Leak anyways, because I basically want anything that I can cast this turn. So I bridge into this Supreme Verdict nicely, because I assume that Once I Supreme Verdict them, it will be very hard for them to win. So I wonder if I even want this untapped. So basically, if I play this untapped, it's because I want to snap opt, and I wonder if I want to snap opt this turn. If there's anything that makes me want to snap opt instead of just going Mana Leak on something like Heliod. Because there's no reason to lose this Snapcaster really to Verdict. So I think I'm just gonna play it tapped. Also saves me 2 life, which is usually not that relevant against Heliod. But sometimes it is, so might as well do that. some danger to playing this Godless Shrine last turn and playing Godless Shrine now is that there is a very small chance that they will sacrifice Ranger Captain of Eos in response to me fetching. Okay, so if their last two cards, one of their cards is definitely Ballista. If the other is Company, they need precisely Heliod plus Conclave Mentor to win. So I think I'm just gonna go for Verdict. I also don't have a reasonable way to outplay Heliod plus Conclave Mentor line down the line, because I would need... If I had push, then I will be more likely to wait one more turn, because I have fifth land. But as it is, I think it's just better to... It's just better to Supreme Verdict now. And they don't have Company, everything is, as they say, Gucci. So we should be fine now. Okay. This is either Ballista or Company, but I assume it's Ballista because they are paying the cost in a way that indicates it's the next spell. And I'm gonna play the Fairy. I'm gonna plus. And then if they attack Ballista, or attack the Fairy with Ballista, I'm gonna let it go. And then if they ever pump, I'm just gonna eliminate in response. So they can only deal 4 damage total to the Fairy. And if they wait with the pump, I can just... Yeah, I will plus the Fairy now, so I get to just deal with this Ballista, even if they don't pump. I'm gonna float this mana just to eliminate if I want to eliminate, then I want to have this mana untapped. For the return, obviously. I guess there was better to tap black-blue, since it conceals a bit better what I'm trying to do. But I think if I'm tapping black-white, it's fairly obvious. I want to kill their creature. Okay, and that's enough for them to concede. So, yeah, as I've said multiple times, I think Heliod is the best deck in Modern right now. And also, I think that Esper is pretty good against it. So the way I like to sideboard in this matchup is to... Just give me a second. Okay. I'm taking Chaos Guiles. I'm basically trimming the more top heavy clunky cards, and then I'm bringing in some cheaper means of interaction. I don't know how good the second eliminate is. I think it's close to have Eliminator or Snapcaster Mage, and I think I'm actually gonna lean on Snapcaster Mage, lean towards Snapcaster Mage over second Eliminate, since Snapcaster Mage can also be a counterspell. So Teferi Time Raveler is a pretty decent postboard card against Heliod, I think, because it makes Veil of Summer much worse, and it forces them to companion on their own turn, which means that your force of negation would be also much better. Okay, this is an unkeepable hand, sadly. They mulligan to 6 as well, once again. And now we are presented with a decent 6-card hand. They mulligan to 5. I'm gonna bottom one of these Teferi's Hero of the Minaria, which is, I think, quite easy. And we have a fairly nice curve of Spellstone slash push into hopefully Supreme Verdict Teferi, just as we did last game, basically. Also, push is better against them than against a regular Heliod build because they have more mana dorks and they don't have Utopia Sprawls. Not gonna fetch, there is no need to. Also, if I fetch, it's somewhat possible that they will just in response crack their own fetch land and play Ladam Riskol, and I'd rather spell snare it if I can. Another thing that's also worth keeping in mind is that because they sometimes have choke in their deck. If you drive filter land like Mystic Gate, I think it's almost always better to go for Godless Shrine over a blue dual, so the choke hurts you less. I'm gonna kill it, even though they can Ladamrish call in response or Veil of Summer, because if they Veil now, this means they don't have a Veil for later, when it's actually important. And if they don't have Veil, that means that their bird is dead and they can't companion next turn. So it's very it's in general pretty hard to play around the Veil in this matchup completely. You just have to pick your spots where Veil isn't that scary, basically. Okay, I'm gonna do this because I don't have a counter spell for the company. So my best bet is to stop company this way. Company, and sadly we don't have a third land still. See what they hit. Okay, so that's the whole combo, basically. That's very unlucky for us. But it's still not lost. If I draw a fetch land, it should be pretty decent for us. Even a non-fetched land is still okay. They need 6 mana to... Okay. Sure. Yeah, I can't do anything in response, so I'm not gonna. If they play Spike Feeder, I don't care at all. One of the reasons I think this is a decent matchup for control is that you can beat Infinite Life with ease, so I'm usually not really concerned about about the Infinite Life aspect of them in general. So yeah, I'm just gonna skip in the video to the point in which they got enough life for their liking, even though, as I've said, the amount of life they have is basically irrelevant with Teferi and Jace. Okay, so they decided to go to 55. And in general, I think I'm in a very good position now. And I think this last turn showed their unfamiliarity with the matchup, because they used one of their most valuable defensive tools, which is Ranger Captain of Eos triggered ability, or activated ability rather, to force through Spike Feeder, which is basically an inconsequential piece of cardboard in the matchup. I think I can wait one more turn at least. Okay, now I have Force of Negation, which means that I can deal with Force of with their collected company if they proceed to do something like end of turn company in response to my cryptic command on their spike feeder. If they go for company here, I think I have two lines. I can either let it resolve and hope that they don't hit Conclave Mentor, but I think the better line to take here is to counter the company and return Heliod to their hand. With this line, they are I'm guaranteed that I live next through next turn unless they top deck Conclave Mentor, because I know that their last card is Walking Ballista. And they can't even canopy for it. They have to play Heliod and have Conclave Mentor as well. So I still think pretty good about my chances here. One slightly annoying thing is that now I don't have an out to Ballista. So this is a bit annoying. And here I think I'm just passing once again. One thing that this spike feeder can do, which is kind of annoying, is that they can use it to I'm gonna spell service champion. They can use it to gain life and put counters on Ballista. But right now I'm gonna use the Snapcaster Mage. I'm gonna target Fatal Push. I'm gonna block Spike Feeder and I'm gonna have push. So if they play a Ballista post combat, I can push it. And if they don't, I'm just gonna spike push their Spike Feeder in the end step. And if they Veil of Summer this, I'm gonna Force of Negation on Supreme Verdict. Illadamri's Call. I think I'm gonna force this because these Supreme Verdicts are likely fairly low impact at this point, and at least the second copy. And this Force of Negation can really attack any good targets anymore as well. Okay, Mana Leak is a very nice draw, especially if I manage to draw land 5. Because I can Teferi into Mana Leak, which is a very powerful sequence, usually. Yeah, once again, I don't really care about the Spike Feeder. Okay, I drew land number 5. I'm gonna fetch a Swamp. Since that I've said before, Choke can be a consideration, and thanks to Mystic Gate, I have all my mana. I'm gonna play the Ferient Plus. And I should be safe from their combo. Okay. Yeah, once again, they are going for some life. Okay, they just went for one loop, so to speak, so I guess there's no need for that. I'm gonna untap Mystic Gate and Drowned Catacombs, since I think it represents the most broad array of answers that I can possibly have in my hand. If they top deck a land, They can go ballista for one. And then pay for my mana leak, remove one counter, and then give lifelink. But if they are going ballista for two, which it seems, it looks like they do, I will just mana leak this. And even if they have Veil of Summer, unless they have one more land, they can't win this turn, and I will just verdict their board. Okay. So it looks like opponent had enough. So it's a fairly quick 2-0 against Heliod.